came back from my trip to West Africa, and I showed my family the photos that I had taken in Senegal and Ghana, their reaction was really different from mine. They were shocked at a lot of the situations that I saw there, and it was sort of an aha moment for myself in remembering that a lot of the content that I deal with in my work is something that most people here in the U.S. just don't have exposure to. One of the realities of being in Africa is that kids follow you everywhere you go, especially if you have a camera. So here, my colleague Chris Hofstetter was attempting to video record the schoolyard in Pekin, and the class let out, and his attempts were completely thwarted because the kids just flocked to him. This chart really stood out to me because it measures a child's malnourishment. And on this chart, the focus is whether or not your child is underweight rather than overweight. The focus is exactly the opposite of what it is in the U.S., where a lot of our health problems stem from an overabundance rather than a lack. At one point, I was walking by when a group of people were collecting water from this community water pump. And it also really stood out to me because at home I have two faucets, probably within about 10 feet of each other. And when I turn them on, I just get water in a seemingly endless supply. And this was a reminder that a lot of people all over the world have to travel a distance to get their water and from a large shared source. One thing I saw a lot was cocoa beans drying in the sun. And I imagine they probably dried pretty quickly because I've never felt heat like the heat I felt in Ghana. It was really amazing. My colleague, Moses Kanga, who works for our partner organization, Wacom, handed me an open cocoa pod at one point so that I could have a taste of the seeds. And it wasn't until after I started chewing them that he said, no, you don't want to chew them. You want to just kind of suck on them to get the coating off. And they were much better that way. And it also struck me that here's something that I've thought I was completely familiar with since I was a little kid. And it looked and tasted and felt completely different in its original state. As a designer, one of the things that stood out to me was just the visuals. I'm used to working with modern architecture and clean lines and things like that. And when we were in Africa, it was all about color and texture. And so I just couldn't stop taking pictures like this one where, you know, I'd be walking down a pathway and I'd turn and there's just this building with this incredible rich blue line painted on it amidst all these earth tones and a white backdrop. Or I'd be walking along and underneath these rice bags that were used to provide shade and the way that it would filter the light to these pinks and yellows and blues and things and walls that had been painted where some of it had been eroded and just the rich texture that came through with all these bright colors. Or shutters that were painted bright blue on just in the middle of this, you know, earth tone wall. And a lot of these visuals just really stood out to me, and I couldn't get enough of them. It's something that I'll definitely take with me forever.